Hi, my name is Amit Durve, and I've been Dr Vikas Agrawal's patient for severe obstructive sleep apnea. I've been having this problem for a good decade or so. It got enhanced with my weight gain since the last year and a half. I had initially gotten this diagnosed and checked in Singapore at Singapore General Hospital with Dr To, and I also had goiters on my left thyroid, so that also was an operation that needed to be done. The doctors in Singapore advised there would be needed two or three separate surgeries to cover the goiter and the sleep apnea. A single combined surgery would go on for 6 to 7 hours, so they were not quite keen on doing that. Since I am from India and Mumbai, so I decided to come back over here to get these surgeries. Dr. Vikas Agarwal's name was recommended by Dr. To over there, and over here by another separate doctor that I went to for consultation as well, recommended me to Dr. Vikas. His name is Kirtane. Yeah, Dr. Kirtane. So I was told that Dr. Vikas Agarwal is the pioneer in this field in India, so better go to him for that. So since I got Dr. Agarwal's recommendation from two separate doctors, I met him, and we met a few times, discussed, and going with his recommendation, we decided to go for a single surgery that would take care of the left hemithyroidectomy as well as the nasal and the oral throat cavity, tongue, a lot of surgeries which I can't even name were going to be done. So we decided to do a tracheostomy, and so that Dr. Vikas Agarwal would have a free hand in doing all the work that he needed to do inside my palate mostly. And it's been now more than 2 weeks. I stayed in the hospital for 2 weeks because of the tracheostomy tube, and it's been 3 days now since the tube has been taken out, and I had absolutely fine recovery. Pain levels were so minimal that even without painkillers, I would have managed from day one. To be very honest, on a scale of 5 to 6 was what pain I had in my throat because of the surgery, and which for me is quite manageable without even the painkillers. The recovery went quite smoothly, and no complications.
So with the tracheostomy tube, you were able to speak, or you were not able to speak?
I was able to speak. With my fingers, even now with the hole that is still there, I just need to keep my finger over there so that the air doesn't escape. Now I'm speaking much better. I'm speaking a lot more. With the tube, I could speak, but I was avoiding speaking because there was infection ka this thing. So
yeah, the idea is that you're not handicapped with the tracheostomy.
No, I was not. Absolutely not.
You were able to put your hands
from day 3 or 4 after the surgery. I could start. Or I tried to speak, and I could small sentences without much discomfort. I could do it.
And after removal of tracheostomy, how was your sleep?
It has been much better. Earlier, I could not even rest on my back for more than 2-3 minutes because I used to start choking. Literally, physically, I could feel that the air is going in, but I can't exhale. That level of choking I used to have. So now I can very well lay on my back, and
so you know that we have removed a part of your soft palate, we have removed a part of your tongue.
Yes.
And we did a tracheostomy. Do you see any change in voice from what it was before?
No, the voice has not changed
at
only
all.
Yeah, but as in if I'm closing the opening, which
that's
it
fine.
Would
that's
normally
fine.
Be my voice is
same
as it was before. No change or discomfort in speaking, no pain, nothing. In 2 weeks, I'm absolutely pain-free, so to say.
Great.